I'm going to be asking you any such incidents that you have had in your life wherein you have seen limitless results because of that one thought that changed you. Anyone? I know Rachna here had some incidents like that wherein she was a rider. Anyone knows that she was a cyclist before she was a runner?
Yeah, they know. Please share that story.
So, yes, please share that story.
It's a long story.
It's okay.
Yeah, I met with an accident about 2013 and by cycling, and I thought various emotions whether I'd be able to get back to do anything at all. Then I just decided, no, I'm not going to be just sitting and not doing anything. I decided that okay, cycling was banned for me because my family got very emotional about the whole thing. So I got into running accidentally, and ever since, it's no looking back. I just went on.
So that's one example, very clear example of how she turned something that could have, you know, stopped her from other possibilities. Now she's a very well-known runner. All of us are so inspired by her. In fact, I want to become like her. Like the way we all talk about her fitness, I can't do a push-up, okay? So the way I've seen her do push-ups, it's crazy, right? So things like that, you know, how she's turned herself into a very inspiring person just because of, you know, she didn't take that as, okay, cycling is banned, so I can't do anything. So beyond that, what can I do? So that's where limitlessness begins, right? Anyone else with some incident that you have had? Anyone who wants to share?
Yes, ma'am. I don't know whether it correlates with what you are saying. In 2015, I mean, my habit once I start running, never to miss another. That is, I have been, that's good. The last 8 years I have been running, I never missed that marathon. School runners, I had high fever, 105, headache, and cold, everything. So I didn't tell my wife also. I wanted to run. Next day morning is the marathon, half marathon. I had to run. But that, I know I was pretty weak. I couldn't run. I think Arvind, the coach, was running with me till the 10 kilometer. I felt so weak that I couldn't continue. But something inside me told me that I should not give up. And I was able to complete the run. Maybe it took me about 2 hours, 30 minutes. I believe in that Stephen Covey is like start with a beginning or end in mind. That's what I said. I have to finish that run. Maybe that one experience running has given me.
Thank you. That's a very good example as well. That's a very nice incident. That's why all of us look up to you, right? Anyone else for anything else? Ranish, would you like to say something?
To me, limitless begins within. It started with all not knowing what the term marathon was until I came across Viji. And so I was in a session. I was doing NLP, one of the training sessions that I had attended, and I came across Viji. The facilitator told she's a person who helps or guides people into running. So to me, marathon never existed. And then I was so fascinated with this term that I went upon and I asked to her, like, can you help me getting into running and marathon? And she told, why not? And this was right in 2016 that I started. I couldn't even run 200 meters, although I used to go gym. And then right from 200 meters until about 30 kilometers is what I've touched. And I wish to do more. As a runner, we have so many who've achieved a lot. So to me, limitless begins right within. To me, running never existed. To me, it was all gymming. Why do people run on the road? What is so there? And once I started tasting that, it was phenomenal. Early in the morning, where the city is sleeping, it's at its best. And so, to me, that's what is limitless begins within. Yes.
Yeah.
Having said that, setting the right tone over here, I would like to welcome each and every group. We have heads and representatives of Dream Runners, we have heads and representatives of Chennai Runners, we have EC Runners over here, we have Marina Runners over here, we've got Godspeed Runners over here. So we have quite a lot of running community over here to support running itself as such. And for the cause of cerebral palsy is what we believe in. There are different causes as well, definitely, but for us it's cerebral palsy because it's close to heart. We have a person with that. Having said that, yes, so there we go. We are kickstarting, like, with introducing each ambassador. So who do we have here right now?
I'll give you a short description and you can guess who it is.
Okay,
so this person would, you know, he's a, you know, he has this beautiful pose that he gives while he finishes.
How did you come across this pose altogether? We all would love to know. I'm sure a lot of people imitate that.
This was around 2012 Cool Runners Half Marathon. And while finishing it, I was actually running with Swami. He was just enjoying the run. It was a nice chatty run we just did. And towards the end, one among the Cool Runners, I know many of might not know, Sundar Purush, he just came in a bike. He said, "Shahul bhai, you should be running this. Come, come, come." He just dragged me along, pacing me in a bike. And then I started sprinting. Towards the end, he said, like, another few meters, come on, don't, I mean, I said, like, enough, enough. I kept saying, like, enough. He said, "No, Shahul bhai, you can do, come, come." And then towards the thing, finish line, he said, "There you go, the finish line is there, enjoy." He said, I started, you know, like, open out my arms and finished it. It was like more like joy of running, you know, experiencing the joy of running. So that was captured by Ramni sir. He was a photographer there, and that I always wanted a nice running photo. That became one of the best running photos for me. I still have it in my phone. So that I just saw. From then on, every single run, even if it is a practice run also, when I'm just finishing, I just enjoy to, you know, like, open out the arms. You feel like as if you're flying. You feel that feel. I mean, the true joy of running comes from you. Make you feel you're flying. That's why I just started doing it.
Thank you so much for adding that. I mean, that's what people wanted to know. A lot of people keep asking, why did you come up with this pose altogether? So yes, this is Shahul Ameed, one of our running ambassadors. Yes, so who do we have next? Being the face of ARC, and you must have seen the person along with Vinoda.
It is, yes.
So unfortunately, we do not have him over here. He's traveling. So yes, he's one of our another running ambassador. For him, podium is his bed, and that's what we believe in. And he's been one of the most influential person. There are a lot. One of the influential runners in Chennai who help people do better at running. Yes. And so who do we have next? Ketna.
So this person, he ran the Berlin recently.
Yeah. Berlin Wall?
Yeah. That's the wall.
Yeah.
That's Yasir there.
Yes.
Welcome, Yasir.
Thank you. Thank
yes. Okay. So one question to you. Just before, like, reaching the finishing line, just 1 minute before that. Yeah. What was clogging your head? What is it that you were thinking?
Yeah, so Berlin, so I ran the Berlin Marathon September last year, this year. So the practice was happening, you know, I was training diligently, and this finish line pose was something that I practiced too. You're finishing a world major, you know, you have to look your best, right? You know, when you're crossing the finish line. So, I think most of you all would have seen that photo. I was in tears, you know, I was, because 2 hours back, I was in the 30th kilometer mark, not able to move an inch, you know, because I had hit the dreaded wall, you know, what you call in the runner's thing. So, it's probably the inner strength that I had, which made me cross the 10 kilometers, you know, to make it. So when I saw that finish line, and you know, when I just recollected what happened back then, and to be there was something very special, you know. So I couldn't just hold it back, and I had to let it out. So there was something natural, and you know, as my blog, it became a big hit. Everyone were crying along with me. That's what happened. Okay. And thanks to Viji for having me here. I'm probably the weakling among the.
No, you're not. See,
you
made people emotional.
So I'm happy. I'm happy for
you
this.
You inspired so many people. So.
Thank you. So I'm happy for this recognition and and being part of all you experienced runners.
Thank you.
And so we have a person over here whose journey into running has been just an accident. Okay, and that incident changed his life. He was a person who used to sit in the college days, sitting, listening to the lectures. And so one fine day, one person comes as a guest lecturer. The person listens to the whole story and gets fascinated. What is this running? And there goes his journey, right from healthy to being fit. And he's one of the speedsters in and across the Chennai running community. Who do you think it is?
Do you think it's Shri Krishna?
No. Yes. Shri, it's to you. Yes. 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 So, how did it really go?
See, I was just sitting in the college actually. I was observing Mr. Swaminathan and Viji Swaminathan talk. And over the period of time, in 2 years' time, like, I was just looking at this lady, like, from she was just somewhere, she was just fat, and now she's. No, fitting super. So just that, though, I just asked the same thing like what Ranish was saying, and I'm just asking her like, how does it happen? No, sorry, I didn't even ask her. Like, okay, this is also possible. And over the period of time of seeing her, and this started off my running as well. And I got to know that through Facebook, I got to know that this is a story. And the same way, like I was also following this stuff. That's it. So like everyone, like I do also have fat to fit story. So I was over the period of time, like by 2014, like 93 kg. So somewhere now, so like till yesterday, like 64.5. Now that 64.5, this is my race weight, and which I've just started off my stuff. Started looking at this. So it is very nice being part of this particular UNIS, and I'm so super proud of it. Thank you.
Krishnan, I'm going to wait anyhow.
Thank you so much for sharing that. And before we go across our another running ambassador, you see over here, we've got a noble heart. We've got a person who's been supporting us in conducting the whole run. It's a venue that matters the most, where we start from, and I'm sure each of us loves running the scenic route of ECR, don't you?
Yes,
and that's what we look forward to. The route, the coastal line, the Muthukar bridge that you cross and you go ahead. But beyond that, we would want to know, what is it that Udeep saw in ISHM 2017. We have Mr. Udeep over here, who's been fortunate enough to help us with the venue, and he's been a noble heart in that. So yes,
thanks.
Too many kind words. So I think I like the 94 to 64 story. 91.5, so maybe I can get
it. That's why
I
caught you.
No, see, what we're doing is actually helping a very good cause. So when Viji met me with Ranish a couple of years back, the only thing I told her is, see, what we are doing is something, the easier part of it. What you guys are doing is the tougher grind. So think Mahajaal is your property forever. Till you want to do this, even if you keep doing it, and ask us what you want us to do, we'll help you with it. So that's the thing. We're always for that. It's always been a family entertainment center. Recently, we've done up the whole property for the second generation after almost 15 years. So, and a lot more events, a lot more good, the idea is to do something good, something back to the society also, not just, business, not only to earn profits and, give returns to shareholders. That's about it. Okay, so I'm not much to talk on, Radhi. Thank you. All the best.
Mapping over here. Thank you, Mr. Rudeep. And so who do we have next?
So this person started running only when he was 50, I think. Only in his 50s?
50? Who do we have over here beyond 50?
But they don't look
they don't
so
look 50,
above.
Okay,
yeah. The person doesn't look pure
above. Okay, so who do you think it is over here? We have quite a lot of people beyond
50. Yeah,
yeah.
No, but this person started running when he was I think 55. Is it?
So it's not definitely Shahul over here.
Yeah, then he just turned 50, so that's 60.
50, 60. Yes. So who's it? Any guesses?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Exactly. Let's welcome Mr. Sohan.
He only looks like that, but definitely his journey in running is phenomenal. And so, you're 10 years or plus in running?
No.
Then so he's trying to
I started at 56.
Yes, okay. So, how's the journey been all through?
Journey has been wonderful. I entered running when my life, personal life was in a bit of turmoil. I needed something which can walk me up. And running has really helped me in that. It has been a wonderful journey because of all of you. And I love every runner, right from Sahul. Now he says he has this pose. So I wanted to do something like that. Then I can't do this because he is already complained.
Yeah, trademark already, yes.
So I said I'll do something different. I raised my hand a little bit. So right from people like Sahul, so many people in ISHM2019, Kirtana and Sri, they faced me for my first sub to half marathon. So this event, the first piece came in my heart, and also the Quas CP, that is also very close to my heart, close to me. So this combination of factors make me love this event, and what I do is with the running, even a new runner, I learn every day. A newbie, when he's starting running for 300 meters, that itself is a challenge. So that day itself, that person is a winner. He need not run 42 kilometers to be a winner. The person when he starts his journey of running is a winner. So I think every one of us is a winner, and all runners are a winner. And I love that more and more people join the running, and right now my total focus is on that. I want more people to come out on the roads and run. That's it.
As you said, each person who starts their journey is a winner. It's not about when do you finish, it's about where do you start from. And so with saying that, who do we have next?
So he's one of the most stylish runners.
You mean to say
she color coordinates? Yeah. I don't know. Like you should be asking her.
I think we have a person who color coordinates.
Nandini.
No, we know that.
Color coordinates.
Yes.
We know. Yeah. We all know.
We all know.
Yes.
When I started running, say, 4 years ago, and it was just randomly, a friend said, there's some session by DRHF training, then let's just go. And I just could not run beyond 100 meters, and I was like so embarrassed there. The next day, I said, okay, I have to somehow get into running, and ever since that, it's been a great journey so far, and I love covering miles with smiles, so I'm more into ultras. I'm not worried about my timing at all. As long as I can finish the run happily,
Thank you. question. Yeah, I have a special question. How do you manage to color coordinate so well?
So how many of you wanted to ask this question? Please be frank.
So we need to ask this question.
We all have the question. We all have the question.
Especially in Indian color.
See, how do you do that?
We all have the question.
Not really. I think it just happens randomly.
Yeah, even today. Exactly.
It happens randomly, actually.
Randomly, like today, the main.
So, who do we have next, Danish?
So this person has been running for quite some time, but she's known for the social media philosophies and the gyans. The hashtag running gyans.
Are you talking about the teacher who runs?
No. No. Shantini.
Shantini. Okay.
So you have Shantini. Yes.
I am a person who hated the very idea of running. You know, I never used to run. I mean, like to run even a 50 meters. From then, I have transformed to a person who just loves to run. Anything sad or happy, I just loves to run.
We have next teacher.
Okay, right now we have a teacher who runs. So who do you think it is?
Only one.
What's it? Why are you there?
No, we have Viji.
Is a teacher.
Viji, are you teacher?
No,
Viji
is a teacher.
No.
Dancing queen. Okay, we have other adjectives as well. So the dancing queen, the person who dances along with her daughter.
I have a question for you.
Yes, these are people.
So you run.
Yeah.
You go to school to teach kids.
Yes.
You also dance. How do you really manage this combination of running and then also going to school? I mean,
she also manages two kids.
That's my job, right? Yes. So I'm a teacher. Yes. So which means I need to plan my schedule properly. So when it comes to runs and the practice runs, I do have my own systematic way of planning my morning runs. Like I need to get back home, the same kind of hectic chaos that happens at everybody's place happens here also. So I need to pack lunch for my kids and then send them off. There's a specific time. So what I do is I just plan my runs in such a way that I'm back home by 6:15 or so, and then I'm there to cook and send them off. And when it comes to job and runs, it's because running is my passion, and as a teacher, it's just my job, profession, which I love. So I basically enjoy doing what I love. That's the key thing. Thank you so much.
There you go. It's about enjoying whatever you are doing in your daily routine. It's just not about managing it. It's just about loving what you exactly do. So that's something that we wanted to know from Anthony. And so who do we have next?
We have who all of us call her Kalaivi.
Yeah.
I think you all know her.
Just the name.
I don't think an instruction is required.
So people, yes, you'd be knowing her as Kalaivi. But my question, because I've entered into running pretty late. So my question is, how did this term Kalaivi came into picture?
So, when I wanted to start running, okay, before I start, there's a brief introduction about me. Apologies, I don't think I anywhere match up to all these Dada runners out here. Soni Ji, Shahul, so many of them, all of them are pretty much senior. I'm nowhere near. I'm just a wannabe runner. And I think, so running happened because I have a history of 10 years of strength training and trying very hard to get into, you know, something which also helps me mentally. I have a very stressful job as well. And of course, mom of two kids. So that also adds on to the stress. So when I tried to start running, there were groups which I used to, you know, kind of say that, you know, I want to come and run. And I felt that everybody was going far ahead and they were not waiting for me. So I realized I'll do something, I'll start something in my own area. So we bumped upon this. I kind of sowed the seed for coastal runners. and after some time we had the founder member Harikam also joining. So it all started because I started the Pushdana. I'm too old, so they can't call me by name. All of them are youngsters. So they use this tag Talaivi, so that it sounds respectful and also shows your age is right there. So I just want to say this. You have a question or?
No, yes, you can.
Yeah. So I think I'm a very unconventional runner. I think that's what I think all of you should, I mean, kind of as an ambassador, I'd like to share for people maybe who want to start running. I heard a few of them who just come in to, you know, I want to pass on this message. By physique, no match. Health, really on the low. I have a lot of complications. So when I can, you can. So and I think this is what I would like to share.
Thank you. And that's what we take away from this, that if one person can, then anyone can. We've seen people doing such a long run, such a short, in short time they cover distances. It's anyone can do it if one can do it. And that's what all about it. Yes.
So who's next?
Who's next? So we've got a runner over here who's a small packet big bomb.
Yeah.
And when it goes real speed. You'll see the person flying on the road.
You can't see the person. It's only the vision.
Okay. So who's that? Who's that?
Rocket.
Rocket. And it is right now we have over here. Yes.
So how did you get into running? You know the story, but how, obviously you would have had mind blocks, right?
Actually, very much like Shantanu, I didn't like running. I thought I could never run. Because when I used to go cycling, you look at all these people running, especially on the flyover, what the hell are they doing? You know, repeats and you know, all that. So I think I could never run. And as I said, I got into it accidentally. I said, let me give it a try. Exactly 1 year after this, I ran my first 200 meters in the track field. I said, okay, it's not bad. I think I can do it. And so it went on, and then I joined the Mamadu Mentor. And day one, because one is the VPS cheated me and made me run 10 kilometers on day one.
There he is.
Anyway, so I said, okay, not bad. And I can do it. And
so what about running did you start liking, and you know, how did you?
Yeah, now it's like, I think it's become like an addiction. So I feel something is missing if I don't go for a run. Not every day, but whenever I don't go, I mean, I run 3 to 4 times a week. And apart from that, you need to spend strain, not only running. People should remember that they should take do other things also, other than you could keep yourself fit apart from running, because otherwise you can hurt yourself, you can injure yourself. And one more thing is, I started running in my 40s. I started late. So I was never in school, also I never used to run. So it's not like you can't, there's an age for everything. So you can start even late. It's like Tony and girl over here. So that should never stop you from doing anything. You just have to believe in yourself. That's it.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. It's never too late to start. This is what we've learned from what she mentioned. 40, at the age of starting 40, we have people at the age of 15, beyond 15. And it's just that you have to believe in yourself. And saying that, yes. So, since Rachna has mentioned about VPS, we have Mr. Sendhil over here, VP Sendhil. Now, we would definitely want to know from him, what is this journey been in running through life? So calling on Mr. VP Sendhil over here. Yes. So round of applause for VP Sendhil.
Back to my house.
So, how's your running journey been through?
Ask your runner.
I got a nice family around. Chennai and the family and all the other running communities. That's what the biggest gain for me is. I mean, really enjoying running that way. So, you know, come out of the other numbers and all that. It's more about getting more people and enjoying the whole camaraderie about the runners. That's what I like more about running. One thing about evening, it's such a deceiving evening. All the best for UNIS for this lovely event. The runners of Chennai are really blessed to have such multiple quality events happening. Because now that other cities are not having events, but only city where events organized by the runners is maximum is Chennai. So you get to know what the quality event is all about. So all the best for the event, GMP, and wishing all the other runners
best. Yes, indeed, this is one city where maximum run happens by the runners for the runners. And having said that, Ethna, who do we have next?
So I think right now, are you familiar with this term, Sandesh?
Sandesh? No. I've only had Sandesh as a sweet.
Sandesh?
Sandesh.
I don't know how you pronounce it, but Sandesh. I think it's Sandesh.
Sandesh,
huh? Yeah. I think so. I think all of you will be familiar with that. So,
they are known more for Kesari than Sandesh.
Okay. So,
what is that? Yes, in fact, our ambassador. Sai Ramesh and Sundar Ambal. Yes.
Yes.
Madam, you can have a cash in the
plan.
So, people keep asking, and most of them keep asking, how do they run together? There are a lot of people who run away. They run together. I mean, we can see a lot of couples, I mean, married people over here. How do you guys run together? That's a big question.
Because she makes kesari.
No, okay. That's right. He likes sweets a lot. Even in paper, he likes sweets.
You will not say. No, I don't think. So who started running first and who followed the other?
For him, running is his birth. We are from Gopalapuram. So Gopalapuram run is more than out will be the one. So he is an athlete, he is a player, so he is into fitness. So after getting married, I didn't know anything about the fitness. So after delivering I got into hypothyroid. He was the one who motivated me to go for a walk every day. He used to boil the milk, give me coffee, pick me up. He will give the chair and then wake me up, even when I will not wake up. I will give a big shout.
Even my children used to wake up much better than
So it was like that. So I put on our own nice clothes. So he got me into outside to Marina Beach. So we started our walking. So he used to finish his running schedule and come and take me for a walk. So in one fine day, my clothes went into 20 kilos. So the courage has come, so I have lost 2 kilos. So the next day, I started on my own. Out of this company, I started walking. Then I went into yoga. Then I went into gym. And in my gym, they started a running club. So there it started. 2012, I started at 10 p.m. with him. He was the one who motivated me what I'm here. He is the inner strength for me. anything what I'm doing for fitness is all because he will never say no for anything. So he's like that. So we said, but now I understand what is this now. So when he started telling me, I will not talk to him at all. I used to fight with him for 10 days, I will not talk to him. Because he's making me up in the morning. So, those days. So it was like that. And even when he's abroad, he will call and ask me in Anconia, they used to ask. Sometimes I used to lie also. Then my son, I run with the mama paisura. So then they realized I should not tell lies. That's how I started fitness. That's how. And I love cooking. He also loves to eat. So
and we love to watch.
We love to eat. Our inner strength is told.
That's true. What I'm today, I'm here because I'm a couple ambassador for this big event. I'm here because of
she's lifted having you. We wanted to know who you are. You mean I was unmotivated and I was for inner strength. But suddenly in between I forgot all those things and I got into some serious health issues last year. That was the day she said, "Boy, you pushed me into so much doing all these things and you are not doing this." And she pushed me, last year I started and last
again,
one year
I
started
again.
And I'm a regular now running and it has
so sometimes it's for me, because we are fast and you know, then you have to push ya, push ya. Sometimes it's MTS and you won't have
another
man.
I'm very happy to hear this.
And sometimes I used to be waiting for his hearing.
The moment I say she'll stop. She'll stop off here. So I don't know.
So nice. And it's for a
long pause
and good
clarity.
So nice.
Thanks. Thanks for giving me a chance.
Thank you. So who's next,
Manish? Okay. And before we call upon our next couple numbers, there's been a lot of curiosity in terms of people knowing what exactly is cerebral palsy. A lot of us sitting over here have always thought cerebral palsy is basically a mentally retarded, things like that. So we have a resource person over here who could tell you about what exactly is cerebral palsy and how did we come across cerebral palsy with our event, how did we merge it, how did we associate. So let's have Rashmi Goyal over here on stage. She's a person who's been instrumental in helping those kids with cerebral palsy, and you're the right person to tell about them.
So basically, let me introduce myself. I'm Rashmi, and I'm a very, very nervous speaker. So if at all I fumble, it's all because of Ranish, because he's first into speaking.
I'll be getting the beating.
Definitely, because I've been asking him for the past 2 hours, is it all done right? Can I go? Okay, so I really thank Viji and Ranish for having me speak up over my passionate subject, which is cerebral palsy. And I mean, I'll just give you a little gist of how it happens, unfortunately. And definitely it can happen to anyone, from the richest person on this earth to the poorest of all. I'm sure all of us here, most of us, I think so, more than 95% of us are proud parents of children who have been completely healthy, have developed typically, have run, walked, spoken, everything at the right age. So now can any one of you tell me that which has been your most cherished moment, which you, I mean most precious moment, which you cherish till date in the first year of your child's life? Can anyone tell me?
Mama, Dad.
Sorry?
They start talking.
So all of us have been really fortunate and blessed that our kids have developed typically and have achieved all their milestones at the right age, in the right manner, and they have been healthy. But unfortunately, all parents under the sun are not that fortunate, and sometimes there are some complications which happen during, it could be a genetic issue, so the mother is infected with some fever or some Rh negativity, and there could be some complications during the birth. It could be a delayed labor, or the mother's pelvis size could be a little small, or because of some reason the child does not get oxygen supply to the brain immediately after birth. You must have heard the first cry of the child. As soon as the child comes out, it cries. And whenever you go to the doctors typically ask that did the child cry immediately afterwards. So because of some complication which has happened, not because of any fault of ours or not because of any sins which we have done in the past birth, which typically everybody says that, okay, she must have done something, that is why she's having a child like this. No, it's not at all true. It is just a mere accident. It is not a disease, it's just a condition. which has no treatment at all. It doesn't have a treatment, it has no cure. I mean, if some parents come to me, they said, is it a cure, doctor, is it curable? I said, no, it's not curable. We are together going to manage cerebral palsy. So because of that, the child, there are various causes of cerebral palsy, as I said, and each child who has cerebral palsy has a damage to the brain, and the brain is huge. It's like your junction box. And you have the tube light running, you have the loudspeaker, or you have the 2-in-1, or you have the CD player, everything running, right? So it works at the command of the junction box. If that is switched off, the correct messages are not coming to this thing, and it doesn't light up, or it doesn't, there's no sound, or there's nothing. So similarly, the brain is a controlling, the computer, you can say. So if there is any damage to any part of the brain, it might be the area which controls your speech. It might be an area which helps you hear, it might be an area which helps you see, and most often it is the area which helps us walk and use our hands. So because of this damage, which might be just a millimeter or not even that, it can be just a minuscule. So these children who have had a damage at birth and have had a complicated delivery, they might show symptoms like, normally you must have all gone through it, that at 3 months, the child starts holding the head. At 5 months, the child starts rolling over. At 6 months or about 8 months, the child starts sitting independently. At 10 months, you see the child pulling up and, starting to walk with the furniture. And by about 1 year or one plus, about 18 months is our cutoff date, the child starts walking independently. But these children, because of the brain damage, show a delay in all the motor developmental milestones. And in addition to that, some kids have cognitive developmental delay. They have problems with their vision, and they have problems with their fine motor functions as well. And it so happened that I joined UNIS because of my friend here, Neetu. She said, I always was looking for a company to walk, and then she said, why don't you come over and join UNIS? I said, okay, fine, I'll come, let me see how it is. And then I joined, and Viji inspired me into running. And one day, you might remember that there was some jali cut going on at the beach, Marina Beach. Those protests were going on. And I said, okay, Viji, why can't we take this route of Abhirampuram and go? And we went past our clinic, and she asked me, I said, this is my clinic. She said, do you have a play school? I said, no, I'm a therapist, physiotherapist. So she said, why is all these swings and slides and everything around? I said, yeah, I'm a pediatric physiotherapist. So then I had not specified to her what I was doing actually. She said, what is pediatric physiotherapy? We would like to come and see what you do. I said, fine, you're most welcome. And all of them, like about 7 or 8 of them, dropped in my clinic, and coincidentally, they saw so many angels. It was a different world altogether. I think she'll be a better person to describe how it is. And there she saw a lot of kids. I mean, they are just beautiful. I can tell you, I'm into this field for the past 22 years. And every day I feel that, I thank God that you brought me into this field, which is like very, very satisfying. And she saw one or two poor children. She said, Rashmi, how do these people pay? I said, yeah, Viji, from the start of my career, I've never refused treatment to anybody. Whatever I can do as an individual, and I'm like really blessed that there are some parents who tell me that they come quietly to me and say, Rashmi, if you feel that child needs help and the father is not able to pay, you can tell us, we can sponsor some sessions. Sorry, the child is not able to afford the splints. We can sponsor, and I say, okay, fine, I'll call you when I need. And so with their help and on my own, I've never refused therapy to any child, because I feel being poor is not their choice. And just because a parent is poor, the child doesn't lose the right to walk, talk, or give a first smile to their parents. So that's how it all started. And Viji said, okay, Rashmi, this is the day. I'm going to create awareness about cerebral palsy, and I'm going to help you help more and more children whose parents cannot afford. Because it's not a one-day treatment. When the parents come to me, I just can't give them a bottle of medication and tell them, okay, morning, evening, one spoon, kudunga, sariyadu. That's not the thing. It goes on and on till their entire development completes. And many a times, yeah, we get children with only developmental delays who are fine within a year or so. So that's how it all started, and I'm really proud to be a member of UNIS, which is like going ahead and treat kids with cerebral palsy.
Thank thank you so much, Rajesh, to give each of them sitting over here an insight why and what's the cause behind conducting this event. There's a cause, but indeed the event is also equally professional that we tend to give to the runners of Chennai and across. And with that, Kitra, who do we have next? So can I introduce?
Yeah, I think you should.
Thank you. And so this couple has been oldest in number but youngest at heart. And I can see the smile on your face. Okay. Indeed to say. Any guesses over this?
Kandan
Chandram Party, sir. And Namaskar, ma'am. Yes. Sorry, just try. Yes, no problem. Yes.
So, how did both of you start running together?
Me, I have a different story. Like I was, when I was a youngster, I was an athlete. But I stopped all my physical activities at the age of 25 once I joined a company. My busy official schedule did not allow me to do any sports activities. But after coming to Chennai in 2002, one of my colleagues and a close friend, who was about 125 kgs, he wanted to reduce his weight. That's where it started. I used to go to his house at 5 a.m., wake him up, take him for a 30-minute run. It was a selfish motive. When I can run for him, why can't I do it for myself also? That's where it has started. I was able to help my friend reduce his weight from 125 to 93 something.
Whoa.
So then we used to run in Anna University. Then Ramani Ramayya was one of the great runners. He was the person who has instigated this desire in me, a passion. Why don't you do marathon? I started in 2011 Narowil marathon. It still continues. Hope I will be running as long as I am alive.
And that's what we have over here, Mr. Kandan. He's been instrumental in, creating that excitement and curiosity. How do they run together? Even at this age, and that's what inspires a lot of people when they are moving across, when they're running. So with that, Kitna, who do we get to see next?
We have the two doctors.
Two doctors? Okay.
They are two completely, I don't know how they compete with each other. Maybe they complete each other, so they kind of compete with each other.
But
one is completely into weights, the other one is like he's too stylish. Wait. Yeah.
Okay.
And he's too stylish.
Oh my god.
Now, do you
know
who it is?
Yes.
Anyone else?
Harley
Davidson.
Yes.
Harley Sabavati and Sri Devi over here.
Yes,
guys.
Yes, yes.
Thank you.
Well, thank you, UNIS, for getting us to be a part of this wonderful event. Instant Half Marathon 2019, and thank you again for choosing me as the pacer for 2018 edition. This was probably for the first time we were doing Instant Half Marathon. Believe me, Vinoda should know that was one of the wonderful events we ran together.
Yes.
Almost so beautifully organized. I mean, I'm not glorifying for the sake of glorifying because I'm here, because this is one marathon I'm not going to forget, because that day climate also cooperated so well. The climate was awesome. The first time I actually ran on ECR. And because the 10.5 and the 10.5 and coming back, and at the finish line, I'm sure the same catering people are there, or the food. Okay. I know you do a wonderful job, but whoever did it last time, the food was again awesome. Okay, as far as running is concerned, yes, she was telling me, okay, I mean, I'm somebody who mixes up with workouts. Basically, it's like I do 3 days of weight training, 1 day of cycling, and 2 days of running. That's my own schedule. I have my own schedule pattern, but the 2 days of running, I'm not going to miss it at all, because that gives me so much of pleasure. And looks like they're all very serious, disciplined runners over here, and the one next to me also. I was a backbencher in school, backbencher in college, and of course, I'm proud about that. And I'm sure backbencher in running community also, because, somebody there with me. This is because when sir was telling he had 105 fever and he did 2.5, you know, it's like 2.5 is my where I stayed. You know, it's like my goodness, somebody is there, his fever is being put up. But I'm really, my own priorities are for running is, you just feel happy when you're running, that's all. Nothing else. Okay, I just have to go. I'm not supposed to slog there. My inner strength limits me, you know. Don't push it so much forward. You're a little tired, go there, help yourself with the buffet there, take some nuts. Okay, you're fine, you don't bother about who's going ahead, who's kicking you off. No, not because I feel happy doing that.
Selfies
again. Say hi, but when you see phone, you know, you're so serious. Why are you taking it so serious? You know, it's running, enjoy it. But Ronnie, that's his investment, that gives him the happiness. For me, it's totally different. Okay, and ultimately, that is about marathons, but it's the 2 days, of running, you know, it just, because our job is pretty exhaustive, very exhaustive, physically as well as mentally, because both of us being dentists, I think, you all know that dental job, as a dentist, is very straining, so, but running keeps you totally elevated, that endorphin surges all throughout the 24 hours, you feel happy, okay, you have a positive vibration in you, and you feel like, yes, you're the master, you know, it's like, people run for so many reasons. I run to look good, dress good. Okay. Go back, have a pretty running. Nothing else. Don't put on a tummy. Okay, so you're perfect in shape, that's all. So that you're gonna get it with 10 kilometers, fine. 20 kilometers, fine. No problem. But as far as your priorities are done, your inner strength is okay, they must be there. Okay. So but the total contradictory picture she's gonna give on, because first alarm goes at 3:45, then 3:50, 3:55, then she finishes her run. And she comes back, I start at 5:30. Okay, so off you are.
He made me run. The same story of, I was 89.3 kgs my post delivery. Now at present today, it is 54.5. This was in 2012. He made me to, first he made me to join a gym. In the gym, Mr. and Mrs. Sundarambad, we all started together. Mrs. and Mr. Sundarambad, sorry. So there was a running club in our gym. They made us run. Exactly, we start from our Dimension gym. I think most of you all know the Dimension gym there. From there to Agarpet flyover, hardly it is 1 kilometer, not more than that. I will finish 0.5 kilometer, I will stay in the middle of the flyover, I will stay. No, I can't run.
I will not run
more. No, come, we will go. We 4 hours will vlog together with that. 89 kgs, I started running. Then our first marathon was the Terry Fox 6K run. That was the biggest achievement in my life, that I could run 6K with that body weight. Then slowly I started running, that became a very passionate runner now. Now without running, my day doesn't go without running. So enjoy running, and nice to be a part of this event, UNIS Inner Strength Half Marathon. Thanks for making us an ambassador. Thank you, Viji ma'am.
In fact, Viji, I don't know whether we are like alumni of Dream Runners.
Yes.
2013, when we just thought professionally, let's start like establish as a runner. We used to come check over our like speeches and talk to put your leg like this. The teacher over there, okay, fine, I'm doing it right. This is one of the Sinaka beach, you know, it's like, so already it's like, as you said about the inner strength, you all know it's like, ultimately, I'm sure all of you accept it's just not your physical strength. Right. It's the mental strength which makes you reach the finish line. And when you look back, God, I did 42 or this 21. Okay. Just pictures, Team UNIS. Stay positive, just enjoy running. Try to come into my world of running. Okay. It's more a happier world, not the serious world like Suri's or Sri Devi's. Okay. You're positive.
Thank you.
And having listened to it about how did a lot of people started running with certain seats owned by the group DRHM. Having said that, I'd love to call Mr. Kuzain Lal over here, who represents DRHM. We'd love to know how his journey been like. Yes. So yes, we have Mr. Lal over here from Dream Runners.
Good evening.
We quite see a lot of things in social media that you run quite international runs as well.
So I have not a social media
account. Without him being
without media,
see,
you are in media.
Yeah. Yes. Lead the word social, but still it's all in media. People know
about. I love to run myself and I enjoy running.
Yes. So how's running been to you? Like, how did it all start?
I started with running and it is all about your passion, what you want to do. When achieving goals, getting faster and faster, that's all.
When did you really start running?
2008.
Okay. And how, like, from the journey of 2008, now it's almost a decade.
Decade, yes, 10 years have been. Yeah, earlier we just casual runs, we went without training, we should run 21 kilometers. Today to run 21 kilometers, we've done so much, when to drink water, what to do. It is running now. Earlier it was, like Anand said, it was just a jolly run. Enjoy the run, selfies and walk and run. But now it is all about seeing the time, oh, I can't even drink water for more than 2 hours.
So which one do you miss the most, or which one do you enjoy?
Which one do you prefer the most? Yes. Enjoy the most.
My aerobic runs, casual runs, and my intervals.
And Kirtana, you've been running quite a lot with Lal. So, yes, could you tell something about journey?
I think he's pretty famous for chatty runs. We've had a lot of chatty runs together. And anytime, you know, I think I've done all my first 15K, first 10K, first 21, first 35, I think, with him. And he constantly motivates me to do things, you know. Anytime I, you know, when I'm running alone, I feel very demotivated. I just think of my runs with him and there I go, my dosage of
February run was very famous. Now knowing more about running, getting a little serious, realizing and experiencing the international runs, it's equally important as a journey of a runner. Having said that, Kirtana, who do we have next?
The colorful two. Who do you think it is?
Colorful two.
Doctor. Yes. Yes. Doctor. Yes. There she goes. That's right.
So we have Dr. Kumar and Dr. Radha over here. The colorful two. And we get to know why do we call them as colorful?
Yes. The story goes like what Kannan had, Dr. Kannan had. Actually, I was never a runner, never an athlete, and kind of a bookworm. That's why, you know, we had to choose this profession.
So we are batchmates.
Yeah.
2013.
So it all started with Radha, Prajakta and Amri, the three ladies in our apartment who wanted to run for fitness, and they were searching for somebody in Chennai who can help them in running, and they met this young guy. Where is that boy?
He left
Kannan. So they came in contact with Kannan, and my job was to make sure that I take her to Anna University as well as KK Nagar as a chauffeur. I just reach in the car, wait for the run to be over, and I used to sleep because they started 5 and till they come back by 5:45. I used to be in the car, wait for them. And those days, this was in 2012, so they were planning for their first 10K run. And in Anna University at that time, it was so that it was high, green vegetation were very high and mosquitoes were very, I couldn't sit in the car for a long period of time. So I started moving around. So my wife thought that actually I was warming up and I wanted to run. She couldn't figure out what I was doing at that point of time. I said, now that you're warmed up, let's start the run show. So I owe a lot to Dr. Radha. She made me, inspired me to run.
You owe a lot to my mosquitoes.
So maybe you can give them an answer.
So she inspired me, and when they were running, I could hardly run. Like I said, everybody started, baby steps were very hard for me. And from there onwards, I think we are in the social media. So colors come in my life. So, and we have somebody who keeps inspiring. I think Nandini is there, who keeps makes us change the colors quite often, because it should not be monotonous.
So actually, as you rightly said, I started running first. And I was so happy that he joined me later, because then we could go together. And what I enjoy the most is going together for events. But I think day-to-day runs we couldn't run together, because I'm a little bit slow. And he's fast, so he was always in a hurry to finish early. But nevertheless, we go for events together, and I think that is the most, that's the nice part of it, going together and participating and receiving the medal at the finish line, taking a lot of photographs. And not only that, we have also inspired our kids to run. So my younger son and my elder son, both of them also are part of this running. And he's really motivating me and supporting me for this continuously. So I'm really happy for that. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Raza, for sharing your story, because indeed it is important. So find your mosquitoes so that you start running. People who are still not being into running seriously, maybe find your mosquitoes around. You should probably write a book, Find Your Mosquitoes. So yes, having said that, Kirtana, who do we have next?
It's your chance to interview.
My chance?
Yeah.
Okay, so these are the couple who've run full marathon together. They are silent when you look at them, but they are violent when they are running. And any guesses do we have over here?
Kavita
and Ishwar, yes. We have Kavita and
Let's
Ishwar.
Have them on this.
Thank you, I got Anish here. You're not asking more questions.
So now you get two questions.
Yeah.
Thank you, UNIS team, for choosing us as a master. And thank you for making us part of this good cause. We've been very happy to be a part of this unit. So initially, when they included us, one of my group. So they said that you want to be a ambassador for this. So I was very skeptical. I know it's a new group.
He's just being too modest. It's okay. He's just being too modest.
So when I got introduced, it was actually like a family. I liked a lot about this group. Along with everybody. So our running journey is a little bit up and down. When I started, actually she started first, and she started running in events. So I was living my happy couch potato life, and I was a little bit worried, someday she will trouble me. Luckily, I had a friend who picks her up and dropped her on all running and all, so I was happy that, I'm not troubled. Then came only the trouble where I have to drop her. So why I have to do that? Then a couple of times I have to drop her. Then another day, a big trouble happened. She was preparing for an event, and she asked me, I have to do an LSD. I don't know what is LSD. So I have to accompany her with a route map, with a phone, because she is not savvy and all. So I have to carry a phone with a route map and tell her how to go over a 10-kilometer run. So that time I realized that I can do a 10-kilometer. I ran with her that day. Thanks to my yoga, I've been doing yoga for 10 years. Then, that 10 kilometers changed my complete perception of running. Then I started running, and we were participating in many of the events. Thanks to my group, which was helping us in terms of preparing for all of these events. Then we started going together, and we are lucky that we run on the same pace all the time.
Having said that, from pace, how did you guys ended up running a full marathon together? So how did that happen? Could you just tell us about that?
No, always, full marathon is not in our radar. We don't want to do that actually, because we were happy with 10 and 21.
But a lot of our people, they were doing full and we were very inspired about their story. So we decided we will do one full marathon, and then we started, thanks to Paresh, who's a mentor in full marathon, helped us. He is in Mumbai, but by remote, he was giving all the instructions and training. So we were actually doing a virtual training. A lot of training has happened in the last 6 months, and we were able to do our first full marathon in Hyderabad. We were almost
together. Thank you so much. That is nice knowing about this, your journey as a full marathon.
Yes.
Actually, I was an athlete during my school days. So after maybe 25 years, I started running. One of my friends only introduced me to dream runners, scenic chapter, because she knows that I am into fitness and I am going to gym. Why don't you join a marathon group and you can start running? That's how my
journey into running
has started. After a year, he also.
So you put him?
Yeah.
Come now. Yes.
No,
take care of me. Round of applause for her. Thank you. And just one last question at the end. Why do we have this running ambassador and something called couple ambassador? The running ambassadors is something that we've always heard. Why is that this thing called couple ambassador is coming? Why is it required?
To make family.
To make, to ensure that couple, as a couple, they get into more and more fitness, so that the family, be it the children or be it any other people in your family, influence them to get into fitness. And that's the sole reason of having couple ambassadors. With that, yes, a round of applause for all the running and couple ambassadors. And with that, I would like to thank each and every one being here, and for our vote of thanks, we have Ms. Viji Swaminathan over here.
Okay, happy evening to all of you. From the bottom of my heart, I thank each and every one who has come here. I thank all the chapter heads who could make it convenient to come on a Saturday afternoon. Pardon me for my throat. I lost my voice about a couple of weeks back, and just getting it back now. UNIS is organizing it for the third thing. Of course, half marathon, this is going to be the second time that we are organizing. And as they told you, it is for this cause that we are doing. This running ambassador thing was decided about a couple of weeks back, and we had to do the dates. Almost we decided it in just a week's time. And taking our invitation, all of you have spent almost 2 hours with us. So I thank each and every one. I thank Mr. Rajesh, who's come and represented from Alert the Fund. Thank you so much. I thank Mr. Udeep, who came with us, came here, but then he had to leave because of some work. And all the other chapter heads and running group heads who have come to spend time with us. And all the running ambassadors who are starting their journey of being our running ambassadors from today for the run in a half marathon 2019. I hope to see all of you at the finishing line of the event. Thank you so much.
And Kitana, do you have anything to add?
No, nothing else.
Yes, and so with that, thank you so much from Kitana and from my end for being over here in the celebration and getting to know each other so well. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.